Such a hard some things about Colossians 3. Since then you have been raised with Christ. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God our Father in heaven. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God, in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, whatever belongs to your earthly nature: sexual morality, impurity, lust, evil desires, and greed, which is idolatry. Because of these, the wrath of God is coming, You used to walk in these ways in the life you once lived, but now you must rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie, L-I-E, to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which has been renewed in knowledge in the image of the Creator, which is God, our Heavenly Father. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, He loves us. Clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other. Bear with each other. And forgive. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love. Love which binds them together in perfect unity. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Giving thanks to God the Father who is in heaven through him. Amen. Amen.
Hi. Anyway, first of all, I changed the beginning a little bit. You know, at the very beginning, I show Jesus on there. Anyway, it's actually called Set Your Hearts and Minds on Things Above, okay? Well, there's a chance of rain today, and it's kind of cloudy, and I think it's only supposed to get maybe 47 or somewhere around there, so I was kind of hoping maybe I get to go outside, but it's cold, so I didn't think I'd better. Anyway, open ears now and hear the real God's truth. Amen, amen. Okay. There's a lot of Christmas shoppers out there and stuff, so really be careful, okay? Like I said, I've had people cut in front of me, not using a turning signal, etc., etc. So it's better to be safe and overly cautious, okay? Just take your time, you know. If you're running a little late to get somewhere, still, you gotta be cautious and be careful, okay? All right, now. Set your hearts and minds on things above, as in Colossians 3. Since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God, our Father in heaven. Set your mind on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life, L-I-F-E, is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, L-I-F-E, appears, then you will also appear with him in glory. Put to death, put to death. Give to your cross, and die your sins. On his cross, therefore, whatever belongs to your earthly nature, such as sexual morality, impurity, lust, evil desires, and greed, which is idolatry. Because of these, the wrath of God is coming. So remember that. You used to walk in these ways in the life you once lived, but now you must rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie, L-I-E, to each other, since you have taken off your old self. You have taken off your old self with its practices and have put on a new self, which is being renewed in knowledge in the image of its creator, which is God, our Heavenly Father. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, he loves us dearly, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other, and forgive. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, L-O-V-E, which binds them together in perfect unity. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father and through him. Amen. Now remember, I've been teaching you, as in James 2, that faith and good actions, which is good deeds, work together and is made complete by what we do. So remember that. Romans 2:6. On God's judgment day, remember, at the end we're going to be judged. God will give to each person according to what he has done. To those who by persistence in doing good seek glory, honor, and immortality. He will give eternal life. And I'm also teaching on Christ's 12 apostles, servants, and the end on his second coming. Now let's pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive everyone who is indebted to us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Okay, everybody, let's get the Bibles. Me, I use the NIV version, New International Version. So mine might read a little different than yours. Excuse me. Now remember, Exodus 20 is the Ten Commandments. Abide and obey by them, okay? As you go through life here, amen. Deuteronomy 11, love and obey the Lord your God and keep his requirements, his decrees, his laws, and his commands always. We've stayed on that several times, so remember that as well, okay? Joshua,
W-C-I-C, hey, it's Janine.
1:9, have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous? Do not be terrified, do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Amen. Put your trust and lean on him. Amen. Do all your trials and tribulations here and do the right things. Always remember this, okay? WWJD, what would Jesus do? As you go through, I'm here. What would Jesus do? Ask that question and do the right things. Okay, we stayed on Elijah. He's a prophet of God, our Heavenly Father. Okay. Psalm 24, the earth is the Lord's, and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. So remember that. Amen. In Psalm 46, God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. So remember that. In time of trouble, remember that. He's always here for us. Amen, amen. Like I've told you before, He's been there for me. Twice I had cancer, once I had near-death experience. I know you're probably getting tired of hearing this, but this is also for the newcomers. Twice I've had cancer, once I had near-death experience. Three times I should be dead. The last time I had cancer, I just cried. I mean, I had tumors. Not one tumor, but tumors. I got down hands and knees. I just cried, meditated, fasted for days, for days. And I gave myself to Him. Submitted myself to Him and made Him a promise. Then my tumors disappeared. Amen, amen. This is the real God's truth. And when I had my near-death experience, I've seen both heaven, Jesus, and hell, the devil. So there really are both places. So remember that. So who or what you love, serve, and follow, here's your God. And the second you get up and the second you go to bed is where you're going to end. Between heaven, life with God, our Heavenly Father, or death, dying and suffering hell's fire at the end. Remember that as you go through life here. And the first time I had cancer, I had a small little tiny tumor. And they said it wasn't cancerous when they took a sample. But I demanded it to get taken out. It was just a little tiny thing. But the thing is, but it was cancer, so. And I believe God saved me there as well. Amen, amen. I'm living proof there's a God. Amen, amen. Okay, go to Psalm 105. I like Psalms. Psalms like a poem or a song. Psalm 105. Give thanks to the Lord. Call on His name. Make known among the nations what He has done, what He has done. Sing to Him, sing praise to Him. Tell of all His wonderful acts. Glory in His name. Glory in His holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice, rejoice. Look to the Lord and His strength. Seek His face always. Seek His face always. Remember the wonders He has done? His miracles and the judgment He pronounced? O descendants of Abraham, His servant. O sons of Jacob, His chosen ones. He is the Lord of our God. His judgments are in all the earth. His judgments are in all the earth. In all the earth. He remembers His covenant forever. The word He commanded for 1,000 generations. The covenant He made with Abraham. The oath He swore to Isaac. He confirmed it to Jacob as a decree. To Israel as an everlasting covenant. To you I will give the land of Canaan as a portion you will inherit. When they were but few in number, few indeed, and strangers in it, they wandered from nation to nation, from one kingdom to another. He allowed no one to oppress them. For their sake He rebuked kings. Do not touch My anointed ones. Do My prophets no harm. He called down famine on the land and destroyed all their supplies of food. And He sent a man before them, Joseph, sold as a slave. They bruised His feet with shackles. His neck was put in irons. To what He foretold came to pass. To the word of the Lord proved Him true. The king sent and released him. The ruler of the peoples set him free. He made him master of his household, ruler over all he possessed, to instruct his princes as he pleased, and teach his elders wisdom. Then Israel entered Egypt. Jacob lived as an alien in the land of Ham. The Lord made His people very fruitful. He made them too numerous for their foes. whose hearts he turned to hate his people, to conspire against his servants. He sent Moses, his servant, and Aaron, whom he had chosen. Remember, Aaron was a prophet. They performed his miraculous signs among them, his wonders in the land of Ham. He sent darkness and made the land dark, for they had not rebelled against his words. He turned their waters into blood, causing their fish to die. Their land teemed with frogs, which went up into the bedrooms of their rulers. He spoke, and there came swarms of flies and gnats throughout their country. He turned their rain into hail with lightning throughout their land. He struck down their vines and fig trees and shattered the trees of their country. He spoke and the locusts came, grasshoppers without number. They ate up every green thing in their land, ate up the produce of their soil. Then he struck down all the firstborn in the land, the firstfruits of all their manhood. He brought out Israel laden with silver and gold, and from among their tribes no one faltered. Egypt was glad when they left, because dread of Israel had fallen on them. He spread out a cloud as a covering and a fire to give light at night. They asked, and he brought them quail, and satisfied them with the bread of heaven. Bread of heaven. He opened the rock and water, and that gushed out like river flowed in the desert. For he remembered his holy promise given to his servant Abraham. He brought out his people with rejoicing, his chosen ones with shouts of joy. He gave them the lands of the nations, and they fell heir to what others had toiled for, that they might keep his precepts, and observe his laws. Praise the Lord. Amen, amen. Okay, now we've been studying on the second coming of Christ Jesus, the end. Go to Isaiah 3. See now, the Lord Almighty, is about to take from Jerusalem and Judah both supply and support, all supplies of food and all supplies of water. The hero and warrior, the judge and prophet, the soothsayer and elder, the captain of 50 and men of rank, the counselor, skilled craftsman and cleaver, enchanter. I will make boys their officials, mere children will govern them. People will oppress each other, man against man, neighbor against neighbor. The young will raise up against the old, the base against the honorable. A man will seize one of his brothers at his father's home and say, "You have a cloak. You be our leader. Take charge of this heap of ruins." But in the day he will cry out, "I have no remedy. I have no food or clothing in my house. Do not make me the leader of the people." Jerusalem staggers. Judah's falling. Their words and deeds, their words. And deeds are against the Lord, defying his glorious presence. The look on their face testifies against them. They parade their sin like Saddam. They do not hide it. Woe to them. They have brought disaster upon themselves. Tell the righteous it will be well with them, for they will enjoy the fruit of their deeds. Woe to the wicked, disaster is upon them. They will be paid back for what their hands have done. You suppress my people, woman rule over them. Oh, my people, your guides led you astray. They turn you from the path, the path. The Lord takes his place in court. He rises to judge the people. He rises to judge the people. The Lord enters into judgment, to judgment against the elders and leaders of his people. It is you who have ruined my vineyard. The plunder from the poor is in your house. What do you mean you crushed my people and grinded the faces of the poor, declares the Lord Almighty. The Lord says, the women of Zion are haughty, walking along with outstretched necks, flirting with their eyes, tripping along with men's steps, with ornaments jingle on their necks. Therefore the Lord will bring sores on the heads of the women of Zion. The Lord will make their scalps bald. In that day the Lord will snatch away their finery, the bangles and headbands and crescent necklaces, the earrings and bracelets and veils of the headdresses. Let me say that again. The earrings and bracelets and veils, the headdresses and ankle chains and sashes, the perfume bottles and charms, the signet rings and nose rings, the fine robes and the capes and cloaks, the purses and the mares and the linen garments and tresses and shawls. Instead of fragrance, there will be a stench. Instead of a sash, a rope. Instead of well-dressed hair, baldness. Instead of fine clothes, sackcloth. Instead of beauty, branding. Your men will fall by the sword, your warriors in battle. The gates of Zion will laminate and mourn. Destitute, she will sit on the ground. In that day, seven women will take hold of one man and say, he will eat our own food and provide our own clothes. Only let us be called by your name. Take away our disgrace. The branch of the Lord. Sorry, I started on Isaiah 4. In that day, the branch of the Lord will be beautiful and glorious and glorious. And the fruit of the land will be pride and glory and glory of the survivors in Israel. Those who are left in Zion, who remain in Jerusalem, will be called holy, holy, holy. All who are recorded among the living in Jerusalem. The blood stains from Jerusalem by a spirit of judgment, and a spirit of fire. Then the Lord will create over all of Mount Zion. Remember, I've been teaching you on this as well. The righteous going to live at the end. And those who assemble there, a cloud of smoke by day and a glow of flaming fire by night. Over all the glory will be a canopy. It will be a shelter and a shade from the heat of the day and a refuge and hiding place from storm and rain. Amen, amen. Okay, excuse me. The prophet Jeremiah, we stated about him, and the false prophet Hananiah, that's Jeremiah 28, we studied that. Okay, go to Daniel 4. It's giving me a lot of Bible verses though. Daniel, a faithful servant and prophet of God. King Nicholas. To the people, nations, and men of every language who live in all the world, may you prosper greatly. It is my pleasure to tell you about the miraculous signs and wonders that the Most High God has performed for me. How great are his signs? How mighty is his wonders? His kingdom is an eternal kingdom. Eternal kingdom. Remember that. His dominion endures from generation to generation. I and Akamas was at home in my palace, content and prosperous. I had a dream that made me afraid. As I was lying on my bed, the images and visions that passed through my mind terrified me. So I commanded that all the wise men of Babylon be brought before me to interpret the dream for me. When the magicians, enchanters, astrologers, and diviners came, I told them the dream. But they could not interpret it for me. Finally, Daniel with dreams, sent from God, our Heavenly Father, came into my palace and I told him the dream. He is called Zafrash after the name of my God, and the spirit of the Holy God is in him. I said, Zacharias, chief of the magicians, I know that the spirit of the Holy God is in you, and no mystery is too difficult for you. Here is my dream interpreted for me. These are the visions. Remember, I've been teaching you about interpretation and dreams, gifts of the Holy Spirit. These are the visions I saw while lying in my bed. I looked, and there before me stood a tree in the middle of the land. Its height was enormous. The tree grew large and strong, and its top touched the sky. It was visible to the ends of the earth. Its leaves were beautiful, its fruit abundant, and on it was food for all. Under it, the beasts of the field found shelter, and the birds of the air lived in its branches. From it, every creature was fed. In the vision I saw while lying on my bed, I looked, and there before me was a messenger, a holy one, coming down from heaven. He called in a loud voice, cut down the tree, trim off its branches, strip off its leaves, and scatter its fruit. Let the animals flee from under it, and the birds from its branches. But let the stump and its roots, bound with iron and bronze, remain in the ground, in the grass of the field. Let him be drenched in the dew of heaven, and let him live with the animals among the plants of the earth. Let his mind be changed from that of man, and let him be given the mind of an animal, till seven times pass by for him. The decision is announced by messengers. The Holy One declares the verdict, so that the living may know that the Most High is sovereign over the kingdoms of man, and gives them to anyone he wishes, and sets over them the lowliest of men. This is a dream that I, King Zephaniah, I can't pronounce that, excuse me, had. Now, Zetushus, tell me what it means. For none of the wise men in my kingdom can interpret it for me. But you can, because the spirit of the Holy God is in you. Daniel interprets the dream. Then Daniel, called Zabras, was greatly perplexed for a time, and his thoughts terrified him. So the king said, Zacharias, do not let the dream or its meaning alarm you. But so on answer, my lord, if only the dream applied to your enemies and its meaning to your adversaries, the tree you saw, which grew large and strong, with its top touching the sky, visible to the whole earth, with beautiful leaves and abundant fruit, providing food for all, giving shelter to the beasts of the field, and having nesting place in its branches for the birds of the air, you, O King, are the tree. You have become great and strong. Your greatness has grown until it reaches the sky, and your dominion extends to parts of the earth. You, O King, saw a messenger, a holy one coming down from heaven and saying, cut down the tree and destroy it, but leave the stump bound with iron and bronze in the grass of the field while its roots remain in the ground. Let him be drenched with the dew of heaven. Let him live like the wild animals until seven times pass by for him. This is the interpretation, O King. And this is the decree. The Most High has issued against my Lord the King. You will be driven away from people and will live with the wild animals. You will eat grass like cattle and be drenched with dew of heaven. 7 times will pass by for you until you acknowledge that the Most High is sovereign over the kingdom. Kingdom is a man and gives him to anyone he wishes. The command to leave the stump of the tree with its roots means that your kingdom will be restored to you when you acknowledge that heaven rules. Therefore, O King, be pleased to accept my advice. Renounce your sins by doing what is right. Renounce your sins by doing what is right. What is right? R-I-G-H-T. And your wickedness by being kind to the oppressed. It may be that then your prosperity will continue. All this happened to King Zacharias. I can't pronounce that, excuse me. 12 months later, as the king was walking on the roof of the royal palace of Babylon, he said, "Is not this the great Babylon I have built as a royal residence? For my mighty power and for the glory of my majesty?" The words were still on his lips when a voice came from heaven. This is what the decree. "For you, King Zacharias, your royal authority has been taken from you. You will be driven away from people and will live with the wild animals. You will eat grass like cattle. 7 times will pass by for you until you acknowledge that the Most High is sovereign over the kingdoms of men and men, and gives them to anyone he wishes." Immediately what had been said about the crime was filled. "He was driven away from people and ate grass like cattle. His body was drenched with the dew of heaven until his hair grew like the feathers of an eagle and his nails like the claws of a bird. At the end of that time, I, Zacharias, raised my eyes towards heaven and my sanity was restored. Then I praised the Most High, the Most High, the Most High. I honored and glorified him who lives forever. His dominion is an eternal dominion. His kingdom endures from generation to generation, and all the people and all the peoples of the earth and all the peoples of the earth are regarded as nothing. He does as he pleases with the powers of heaven and the peoples of the earth and the peoples of the earth. No one can hold back his hand or say to him, 'What have you done?'" At the same time that my sanity was restored, my honor and splendor were returned to me for the glory of my kingdom. My advisors and nobles sought me out, and I was restored to my throne and became even greater than before. Now I, Zechariah, praised and exalted the glory and glorify the King of Heaven. Glorify the King of Heaven, the King of Heaven. Because everything he does is right, R-I-G-H-T. And all his ways are just. And those who walk in pride, he is able to humble. Amen. Remember Daniel 6, Daniel and the lions, Daniel, his strong faith in God who protected him. We studied that a while back. Excuse me. Okay, Malachi 1. Go to Malachi 1. He's giving me a lot of Bible verses, so. The sinful priest. An oracle, the word of the Lord to Israel The Lord to Israel through prophet Malachi. "I have loved you, says the Lord, but you ask, 'How have you loved us?' Was not as to Jacob's brother, the Lord says, 'Yes, I have loved Jacob, but that's who I have hated. And I have turned his mountains into a wasteland and left his inheritance to the desert jackals. Excuse me. Ian may say that we have been crushed, we will rebuild the ruins. But this is what the Lord Almighty says. They may build, but I will demolish. They will be called the wicked land, the wicked land of people always under the wrath of the Lord, the Lord. You will see it with your own eyes and say, great is the Lord, even beyond the borders of Israel. A son honors his father, and a servant his master. If I am a father, where is the honor due me? Me. If I am a master, where is the respect due me? Me. Says the Lord Almighty, Lord Almighty. It is you, O priests, who show contempt for my name. But you ask, how have we shown contempt for your name? You place defiled food on my altar. But you ask, how have we defiled you? By saying that the Lord's table is contemptible. When you bring blind animals for sacrifice, remember this is before Jesus Christ was sacrificed. We had to sacrifice the animals to burn offerings for our sins. This is before Christ Jesus was sacrificed on the cross. Okay, let me go back here. Okay, when you bring blind animals for sacrifice, is that not wrong? Then you sacrifice crippled or diseased animals. It is that not wrong? They offered them to your governor. Would he be pleased with you? Would he accept you? Says the Lord Almighty. Now instead of sacrificing animals, we pray and give our sins to the cross. And we let them die, leave them there, and love, serve, and follow our Heavenly Father from this day forward, being faithful to Him. Now, Lord God, to be gracious to us. With such offerings from your hands, will He accept you, says the Lord Almighty. Oh, then that one of you would shut the temple doors so that you would not light useless fires. So that you would not light useless fires on my altar. I am not pleased with you, says the Lord Almighty, and I will accept no offering from your hands. My name will be great among the nations, from the rising to the setting of the sun. In every place, incense and pure offerings will be brought to my name, because my name will be great among the nations, says the Lord Almighty. But you profane it, by saying the Lord's table, it is defiled, and out of its food, it is contemptible. And you say, what a burden. And you sniff at it contemptuously, says the Lord Almighty. When you bring injured, crippled, or diseased animals and offer them as sacrifices, should I accept them from your hand, says the Lord? Cursed. Cursed is the cheat who has an acceptable male in his flock and vows to give it, but then sacrifice a blemished animal to the Lord. For I am a great king, says the Lord Almighty, and my name is to be feared among the nations,
Also mixed in with some favorite classics, maybe some ones you remember from growing up. I love it when you play.
Okay.
version of the Christmas song, because I had that album back in the 70s. But there's a new version of a song that I gotta admit, I've never been a real big fan of it.
Okay.
We just played it a couple of minutes ago by the group Unspoken. Now that's a group we play.
Matthew 5:31. Jesus teaches about divorce. Jesus said, has been said, anyone who divorces his wife must give her a certificate of divorce. But I tell you that anyone who divorces his wife, except for marital unfaithfulness, causes her to become an adulteress. And anyone who marries the divorced woman commits adultery.
That is the question. If you are, you will win a 4-pack of tickets.
Okay, let's see. Excuse me.
An incredible showing of Star Wars Episode 7. A Mornings with the Tracy showing, courtesy of Sherman's.
Recognize my voice, do you?
Do I, yes.
Do you like my Yoda?
I love your Yoda. You are getting enough, my lovely bride.
Excuse me, a lot of Bible verses, so excuse me. Okay. Who might have been teaching you? People might have been judged, mocked, ridiculed, spit on, flogged, and they even killed Jesus Christ. All by and from the strong faith in God, our Heavenly Father.
Fire and water damage restoration and mold remediation for your home or business. Find out more at servicemasters.com.
Okay, excuse me. I keep a lot of these marked just in case. Sometimes I go over these. Well, they're all important Bible verses, but you know what I'm saying. And remember John 8:12, Jesus said to the people, he said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light, L-I-G-H-T, of life, L-I-F-E. Excuse me. Excuse me, a lot of Bible verses, so excuse me. Okay, I remember we've been staying on the 12 apostles, God's Christ has chosen 12 apostles. Go to Acts 11. Okay, this is Apostle Peter. The apostles and the brothers throughout Judea heard that the Gentiles also had received the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcised believers criticized him and said, "You went into the house of the uncircumcised men and ate with them." Peter began to explain everything to them. Precisely as it had happened, I was in the city of Joppa praying, and in a trance I saw a vision. I saw something like a large sheet being let down from heaven by its four corners, and it came down to where I was. I looked into it and saw four-footed animals of the earth, wild beasts, reptiles, and birds of the air. Then I heard a voice telling me, "Get up, Peter, kill and eat." I replied, "Surely not, Lord. Nothing impure or unclean has ever entered my mouth." The voice spoke from heaven a second time, "Do not call anything impure that God has made clean." This happened three times. Right then, three men who had been saying to me from Caesarea stopped at the house where I was staying. The Spirit told me to have no hesitation about going with them. These six brothers also went with me, and we entered the man's house. He told us how he had seen an angel appear in his house and say, "Send to Joppa for Simon, who is called Peter. He will bring you a messenger through which you and all your household will be saved. As I began to speak, the Holy Spirit came on them as he had come on us at the beginning. Then I remember what the Lord said, "John baptizes with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. So if God gave them the same gifts as he gave us, who believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I, to think that I could oppress God?" When they heard this, they had no further objections and praised God, saying, "So then God has granted even the Gentiles repentance into life." Excuse me. Now those who had been scattered by the persecution in connection with Stephen traveled as far as Phoenicia, Cilicia, and Antioch, telling the message to Jews. Some of them, having been from Cyrus and Syrian, went to Antioch and began to speak to Greeks, also telling them the good news about the Lord Jesus. The Lord's hand was with them, and a great number of people believed and turned to the Lord. News of this reached to the ears of the church at Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch.
When he arrived and saw the evil evidence, when he arrived and saw the evidence of the grace of God, he was glad and encouraged them all to remain true to the Lord with all their hearts. To remain true to the Lord with all their hearts, their hearts, their hearts. He was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and faith, full of the Holy Spirit and faith. And a great number of people were brought to the Lord. Then Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul. And then he found him. He brought him to Antioch. So the whole year Barnabas and Saul went with the church and taught great numbers of people. The disciples were called Christians. The disciples were called Christians first at Antioch. So remember that. The disciples were called Christians first at Antioch. Remember that. During this time, some prophets came down from Jerusalem to Antioch. One of them named Agabus. Agabus was a prophet. Stood up, and though the Spirit predicted that a severe famine would spread over the entire Roman world. This happened during the reign of Claudius. The disciples, each according to his ability, decided to provide help for the brothers living in Judea. This they did, sending their gift to the elders by Barnabas and Saul. Amen, amen. Okay, go to Romans 4. Why not get them all done today? Bible verses. Abraham justified by faith. What then shall we say that Abraham, our forefather, discovered in this manner? If in fact Abraham was justified by works, he has something to boast about. But not before God. What does the scripture say? Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness. Righteousness. Now when a man works, his wages are not credited to him as a gift, but as an obligation. However, to the man who does not work, but trusts God who justified the wicked, his faith is credited as righteousness. Righteousness. David says the same thing when he speaks for the blessedness of the man to whom God credits righteousness apart from works. Blessed are they whose transgressions are forgiven, whose sins are covered. Blessed is a man whose sin the Lord will never count against him. And this blessedness only for the circumcised, or also the uncircumcised. We have been saying that Abraham's faith was credited to him as righteousness. Righteousness. Under what? Circumstances. Was it credited? Was it after he was circumcised or before? It was not after, but before. And he received the sign of circumcision, a seal of the righteousness that he had by faith, while he was still uncircumcised. So then he is the father. He is the father of all who believe, but have not been circumcised, in order that righteousness might be credited to them. Excuse me. And that he has also the father of the circumcised, who not only are circumcised, but who also walk in the footsteps of the faith. Footsteps of the faith. But our father Abraham had before he was circumcised. It was not through the law that Abraham and his offspring received the promise that he would be heir of the world, but through the righteousness that comes by faith. For if those who live by law are heirs, faith has no value, and the promise is worthless, because law brings wrath, and where there is no law, there is no transgression. Therefore, the promise comes by faith, so that it may be a grace and may be guaranteed to all Abraham's offspring. Excuse me. I tickled my throat. My throat's dry. Not only to those who are of the law, but also to those who are of the faith of Abraham. He is the father of us all, and it is written that I made you a father of many nations. He is our father in the sight of God, in whom he believed, the God who gives life to the dead, and to the dead, and calls things that are not as though they were. Against the hope, Abraham in hope believed, and so became the father of many nations, just as it had been said to him, so shall your offspring be. Without weakening in his faith, he faced the fact that his body was as good as dead, since he was about 100 years old, and that Sarah's womb was also dead. Yet he did not waver through unbelief regarding the promise of God, but was strengthened by his faith and gave glory to God. Give glory to God. Being fully persuaded that God had power to do what he had promised. This is why it was credited to him as righteousness. The words "it was credited to him" were written not for him alone, but also for us, to whom God will credit righteousness. For us who believe in him who raised Jesus our Lord from the dead, he was delivered over to death for our sins and was raised to life for our justification. Amen. Excuse me. I tickled my throat. Okay, I gotta make this fast. I don't have minutes. Okay, go Colossians 3. Excuse me. Go Colossians 3. What Christians should do. Rules for holy living. Since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above. Where Christ is seated at the right hand of God, our Father in heaven. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. In God, when Christ, who is your life, L-I-F-E, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory, Put to death, give him to the cross. Let him die. Leave him there. Put to death, therefore, whatever belongs to your earthly nature, sexual morality, impurity, lust, evil desires, and greed, which is idolatry. Because of these, the wrath of God is coming. You used to walk in these ways in the life you once lived, but now you must rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie, L-I-E, to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices and have put on a new self, which is being renewed in knowledge, in the image of the Creator, which is God our Heavenly Father. Here there is no Greek or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, sisters, I can't even pronounce that one, slaves or free, but Christ is all and is in all. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, which means you're dearly loved by him, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other. And forgive whatever grievance you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love. Love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. In perfect unity. Excuse me. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts. Since as members of the body, you were called to peace. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom. As you sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. and whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it on the name of the Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God our Father through Him. Excuse me. Wives, submit to your husbands as it is fitting to the Lord. Husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh with them. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord. Fathers, do not embitter your children or they will become discouraged. Slaves, obey your earthly masters in everything, and do it not only when their eye is on you and to win their favor, but with sincerity of heart and reverence to the Lord, for the Lord. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for men. Since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as your reward. It is the Lord Jesus you are serving. Anyone who does wrong will be repaid for his wrong. And there is no favoritism. Amen. Like I said, he's giving me a lot of Bible verses, though. Excuse me. Okay, it's like Second Thessalonians 3. Excuse me. Living in the light of Christ's return. Finally, brothers, pray for us that the message of the Lord may spread rapidly and be honorable, just as it was with you, and pray that we may be delivered from wicked and evil men, for not everyone has faith. But the Lord is faithful, and He will strengthen and protect you from the evil one. We have confidence in the Lord that you are doing and will continue to do things we command. May the Lord direct your hearts into God's love and Christ's perseverance. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we command you, brothers, to keep away from every brother who is idle, and does not live according to the teaching you receive from us. For you yourselves know how you ought to follow our example. We were not idle when we were with you, nor did we eat anyone's food without paying for it. On the contrary, we worked night and day, laboring and toiling, so that we would not be a burden to any of you. We did this not because we do not have the right to such help, but in order to make ourselves a model, M-O-D-E-L, for you to follow. For even when we were with you, we gave you this rule. If a man will not work, he shall not eat. We hear that some among you are idle, I-D-L-E, idle. They are not busy. They are busybodies. Such people we command and urge in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to settle down and earn the bread they eat. And as for you, brothers, never tire of doing what is right, R-I-G-H-T. If anyone does not obey our instruction in this letter, take special note of him.
Do not associate with him. Do not associate with him in order that we may feel ashamed. But do not regard him as an enemy, but want him as a brother. Now may the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with you all. I, Apostle Paul, write the scripture in my hand, which the distinguishing mark in all my letters is known all right. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen. Amen. Excuse me. Anyway, I gotta finish the rest of these because I'm running out of minutes because I got one song. So, I'm gonna remark this. Okay. Now, excuse me. Number one, let's serve, follow, and be faithful to God, Heavenly Father. Number two, love and take care of your personal family, your spouse, and children. Number three comes work 40, 50 hours a week. Number four comes your friends. My number one purpose for my organization is preach the gospel, the real God's truth. Number two is help people. Number three is help clean up our major cities and make them a better, safer place to live. I've been with the governor, Bruce Warner, on some issues, Mayor Jim Ardis, City Council, and City Council on some issues such as donating the land to my organization that's for sale, and near a school for a project for them, a garden and a wall, and call it a wall dreams for them to paint and put their dreams on it for them in their future, and to help make our city as well, to keep them, to help our city as well, to keep them from the streets, to close places that does massages and prostitution at them, for our city as well, to help make it a better one. A pole light that's needed at Glen Oak Wooden Park playground for the children's safety, and a fence around the playground where two small children have drowned, that's on the riverfront, for their safety. I've been on TV for the matter as well a few weeks ago. I'm asking for donations for the fence issue and the land that's for sale near a school for them. Thank you, and God bless you for it. If you donate, thank you. If you don't have a PayPal account, excuse me, there's a place on there to click on and use your credit cards or ATM cards. I have two videos on my site and songs you can download as well. I've done my biography with my picture summary about my first novel. Now I need to write the first paragraphs of each chapter and a few other things that needs done first. Then I'll send them to a publisher in Chicago. Then the publisher will go from there. And I've recorded 8 more songs. My band's called The Light of Seraphim, Seraphim's an Angel. It'll be after the holidays, and the WCIC radio station will change and play more new music. Excuse me. I got allergies. I've given a trucker a flyer with my sign on it and told him to tell other truckers to watch my sermon on the Wi-Fi. I fixed that furniture. I'm going to college to be the military spelling substitute pastor and counselor. I've got my Christmas shopping done. Yay! So that's cool. Now I need to get the fixings for my Christmas dinner. Then I'll be all set and ready for it. Get a birthday cake for Jesus. I do every year, celebrate his birthday. That's his purpose. Our Savior's born on Christmas and died and suffered on Easter for us and our sins over 30 years later. And rose on the third day, conquered death for us. So we are to live our lives for and through him. Love him first as he loves and loves us. Versus his children, excuse me, who are faithful to him and is made holy and righteous. So we can live with him at the end and live eternally in his kingdom, in his love, peace, joy, and light, and in his total peace forever. Amen. Excuse me. Like I said, I got major allergies. I think I'm allergic to something in my house. Okay.
before a California shooting killed 14 and 17 that was wounded for the victims and families. A bombing attack in Paris. Excuse me. When the 29 were killed and 352 injured. For the victims and families. In Mexico, a hurricane for the victims. Airplane MH370 that's missing for the families. South Carolina's flood for the victims. Charles earthquake from a few weeks ago for the victims. Syrian refugees crisis for the victims. Washington State wildfire from weeks ago for the victims. Earthquakes in Nepal from months ago for the victims. California's wildfire and drought for the victims. Dan, he has health problems. Margarita, she has health problems. David, he has severe asthma. John, Heather, Donald, and his two older teenage daughters, they are going through something personal. Katie's father, my youngest daughter's best friend's father that passed away last weekend for her and her family. Our president, his hard work and caring for our country, I mean, I'm in there. Rulers of our states and cities, schools, colleges, cities. Farmers, bus drivers, teachers, parents, grandparents, children, policemen and women, firemen and women, servicemen and women. I'm praying for you all. Pray for each other, my organization, songs, novels, and house I'm living in. Be careful and cautious. Take your time so you can get to where you are going in peace and safety. And safely, excuse me. So be careful, okay? Thank you and God bless you. I got one song after my sermon, so... Thank you. God bless you.